Very good morning, all of you. Today we'll discuss about the connectivity in between Python and PostgreSQL. So we all know that we learn about the DBMS, RDBMS. So in that section, we learn about how to create table, insert, update, like that stuff. We already learn about that. Now the thing is that just I have one language. I have one front-end language and I want to connect that front-end language with back-end one. Okay, so we all know that all the important or crucial data will be stored in a database, and now if you want to retrieve that database by using a front-end, whatever it may be, for example, Java is there, Python is there. Okay, so by using that, by using code or by using that language, we can retrieve the data. Okay, so by using coding, we can say that. So we will do that operation. So before starting the actual operation of Python and PostgreSQL, just we'll describe what we learned today and how we'll do that. And I will suggest each and every student to do the practical, because it's quite important how we will retrieve the data by using a front-end language. Okay, and that type of questions will be asked in the interview. If you know about that, then they can hire you as a fresher. Okay, so make a note of that while appearing for any interview. So just remember that you need to understand each and every concept clearly so you can appear for the exam. Okay, so let's start with today's lecture. So in that section, we'll discuss about the connectivity. That's it. Assume that we have a database. We all know that we have a PostgreSQL database, in that we have some bunch of amount of tables are there. Okay, so assume that this one is your DB and that contains some important data. Now you have a front-end language. Assume that this one is a front-end language, or we can say that this one is a Python, and you need to access Python, you need to access the DB. DB stands for database, and you have a PostgreSQL DB. You have that DB. In this dot, so just we need to write a code, something like that. So we will connect your database and we will access the DB through Python. Okay. So that means the connection will be made between front end and back end, and here we'll create which library we will use. We'll discuss about that. Don't worry about that. That connection will be occurred in between front end language and the back end language. And whenever, right, for example, I want to retrieve the data from the database, I will provide that query, and that query will be executed, and later on that query will be displayed on the console. Like that stuff, we will do the operation today. And suppose if you want to create a table, suppose if you want to insert the data, suppose if you want to update the data, delete the data, you can do anything. Okay, so just I will show you how we establish the connection in between Python and database. Afterwards, we will do the operation on retrieve, that means select. After do, I will create my table. And just I will hand over to you, and you need to, all students need to perform the practical. Okay, if you have the problem, then let me know, we'll discuss about that. But it is a task to do the rest of operation, which one, insert, update, delete. It's responsibility of all students. Okay. Now we'll start about that. So before starting the application, make a note of that. This is the way. So while connecting the application, that means Python with DB, we need to install one library. Okay. I have that already library. So just I will show you the demo, how we'll install that library. That library must be installed on client side. That means by using that library, we can able to establish the connection, because that library contains some set of predefined functions. By using that function, we can establish the connection. Okay. So for that, just open the command prompt. I will show you everything. So this is my command prompt, and I want to install the library. So make a note of that. Before installing the library, it is mandatory to install the Python. I have that Python, I will show you. So when I click the Python, see Python 3.9.6, and here if I am to perform the operation 2 plus 2 2 minus 4 by that we get the output. That means we can say that we have the library. Okay. So now once we have a library, we can install the package. So that package is PSYCOPG2 binary files. So I will show you. So that will be installed, and we all know that in Windows, if you want to install that, we need to use the pipe. Okay, so here I will use pipe, PIP. If you want to install the any libraries or utilities, so pipe install, I will use PSYCOPG2. After that, I will use a hyphen dash, sorry. And after that, I will use a binary. Okay, so this one is a package, so we need to install. And if we didn't install that package, then we cannot able to use some print file function like con connection. So in that we have comment option, we have cursor option. So we cannot able to do the operation. Make a note of that. Okay. So for that we need to install that library. If you're trying to install, then we can get the other things. So just click it on. It took some time and it will be installed. See warning. You are using a pipe version 21.1.3, aware the version is 21.22 available. That means I don't want to use anything I have already. Okay, so that's why we get this message. Just make a note of that. Just while installing this command, okay, so this is the command. While installing this command, it took some time to install. Okay, so for example, the size will be a 200 KB and that will be installed within a half minute, or we can say that 1 minute. Okay. Once it will be installed, that means we can able to use the functions. Okay. So by using command prompt, we cannot able to establish the connection. So for that, we need to create a Python script, and by using that script, we can establish the connection. So before doing the any operation, or just I will show you step by step, we required a DB and we required a database. So for example, I have that DB. So what should I do? I will create no fresh DB. So to perform the operation, here I will create new DB. The name of DB is my database name. So click on that and check whether the database is created. Now I have that database. So here is my database. So check out whether we have a tables or other things. No, we don't have any tables. So open the DemoCon database and click on the query tool, so we can able to perform the operations. Okay. Right now I don't have a table. So what should I do? I will create first table because we need to do the select operation. And to perform the select operation, we require to use what? We require to use some tables. Okay. So for that, we will do one. We will create one table. In that, we'll do for student related table. Okay. So here, what should I do? Here I will use create command, create table. The name of table will be a student. So inside that I will specify student underscore ID. Okay, so I want to use integer and set this one. Now student underscore will be there. Then we can say that. We all know that the rule of normalization. Here I will use varchar and I will provide a size as 20 only. Must be not null. Similarly, we will create class name also. That name I will use. Just I want to use last address. The underscore. To provide the size will be 200. That also not. My simple table, creating that table inside my DB. Execute it. So we will be successful. Just click on right side, refresh the table, right click it on and refresh it. So check out where the table is created. Right now we have that table, and click on the columns, we'll get the total information about columns. So we have these, see, we have these four columns. Student ID is there, student F name is there, student last name is there, student address is there. Just do one thing, so retrieve all data from that. Don't have any data, just now we don't have data. So just I'm trying to insert the data because I want to perform a select operation. Okay, so if we don't have any data, so how we'll do the retrieve operation? So for that, just we'll do what insert operation, and it's revise part also. So insert name of table. Names, we have that student ID is there. Is there underscore lem is there? These are the my attributes required to store. I will use values. After that, I will pass that. First, I will pass one name is equal to last name. I will enter my last name, comma, and I will enter the address. I'm trying to insert the data inside my table. Yeah, query success return. So we'll insert second value. So use the p it. Just have a little last one. Did my operations, so and just I want to retrieve that information. Just I want to change select all from the whether the value is inserted. Click on that. So we have these in. See, here I'm trying to use a different here is a PS college. So see, PSU database is there, DVCS is database there, and here we have a demo con databases. Okay, so we can select different kinds of terminal also. So now I have the data and I want to access the data from that, and my username is a Postgres. See, here your username is visible, database name is visible, and version name is visible. We require that information. Okay, so once we install that package, see which package, PSYCOPG2 binary, we need to do what? We need to import that package, right? What is the reason behind that? The reason behind that is because this is the library established or created to establish the connection between Python and PostgreSQL. Okay, so for that we require to use that library, because we need to import that library. In that we have option of cursor is there, in that we have option of connection, in that we have option of connect for function. So we can do the various kinds of operations. So just I will open the notepad. It's because I want to write my script, so I can able to retrieve that data. So and terminal, on terminal we cannot able to do that, make a note of that. Okay, and just first of all we'll save that program inside that pp programs. We all know that we store that program inside the pp programs. We do pp programs and I will specify the name ret. Now we need to do the operation. So first of all, import the package. The name of package is psy. That copg as pg2. We need to import that package. Once we installed, we can do the operation. Now we need to create the connection with PostgreSQL. So first of all, we import the package. So that's enough for us. Right now we need to establish the connection. So for that, what should we do? We need to use the con object. Use connection is equals to pg2 dot connect function. Con is equals to pg2 dot connect. So connection interface. In that we need to specify your database name, username and password. So first of all here I will specify my database name. So my database name is database, and after that my database name is demo. This one is my database. So here attribute is their database, and in that we specify your database name and separation by using a comma. Now what will be the username? Who is the user for database? So we all know that. So it's here. So the username is a Postgres. That's a dikhai de raha aapko. So this one is your username. So here we need to specify Postgres. This one is my. That's okay. So this one is my username. We all know that the password is password. Set कर देता हूँ, मैं set किया था admin के time पे और starting में भी तो so our password is password. Make a note of that. It will not ask the password for the PG admin. It will ask the password for while installing the PostgreSQL. Make a note of that. Okay, so PG admin का password नहीं है. So this is the way by using that we can do the connection. So in that con, so first of all we need to do con. After that we need to use pg2 dot connect. After that, in round bracket, this is a predefined function. In the round bracket we will provide the database name as a demo con. After that the username, and all the data will be available in single quote, but will be because it will be work as a string. It will be work as a string, so that will, that's why we need to pass it on the single quote. Now once we did, now we need to set the cursor, because see, everything will be set. Now connection will be established. When I trying to execute that, so for example, see here I will do what? Here I will trying to open the terminal. Click on that CLS and just try to execute that file. Need to set the path pp programs. Set that, just we need to use py ret ret. See, we get the output connection established. Why we get that output? Because we provided a proper information of database name, username. Okay, so if we did not provide the information, then the program will be terminated and the print set will be not executed. Make a note of that. Okay, so for example, just I want to change the password of db. I'm trying to save that program and just see password will be changed and see password authentication failed for the user. ऐसा blindly कुछ भी नहीं करना है हमें. Okay, so we need to understand each and everything. So we get the benefit of internship and so we get the knowledge. Okay, so for that, so we get the error. Just we change the password and this is not proper password. I know that. So password authentication failed for the user Postgres. So for that, just I will use as it is and just again I will use. See, we get the output. So once we get the error, the next statement will not executed. Whatever the language we are using, for example, whether it is a Java, whether it is Python, whether it is any other language. In that case, make a note of that. Error occurs, the program will be terminated because of exception handling. Okay, so in that case the program will be terminated. And why I shown this? Because you need to understand step by step. So you can say that write a Python program to establish the connection between Python and establish the connection between connection using PostgreSQL. So this is your solution. So aisa nahi hai ki chota program hai. So just we need to understand how we'll connect that. What are the attributes are there? So in that section, database is there, user is there, password is there. So what about con? What about pg2? What about the connection? So this one is a variable and this pg2 is a tool available. This one is alias, we all know that. pg2.connect. So that connect method will be available in psy copy or pg2. We can say that pg2 is available. So that's why we are using. We are not doing any code. Okay, just we are using a predefined function to establish the connection. Okay, so once we did that, now we need to do what? We need to set the cursor. Okay, we need to set the cursor. So here I will use cursor, C-U-R as a variable name. And just I want to add the cursor with connection. So connection dot cursor. So this one is also predefined method. Okay, this one is also predefined method. So which is already available. Okay, it's available in con. Con is what? Con is a predefined option. So that means once we stored the information inside the con, then con has a variable, has an additional feature to call the function. So inside that there is a function called as a cursor. So we need to set the cursor. Why we need to set the cursor? Because we need to read the data inside the database from left to right. Okay, so for that, if you want to retrieve the next line, so cursor will be set. So for that it is a mandatory. If we not set this cursor and trying to retrieve the data, we get the error. Okay, make a note of that. This cursor we need to set. Okay, after that, once we set the cursor, now we need to pass the query. Okay, to whom? Postgres SQL query as a string format. That means we need to pass the query. Now we have a table and we have the data also. Okay, so we need to pass the query. So what should I do? I will use this attribute again. All the data information, that cursor property, all will be stored in a cursor, and that cursor dot we need to call a method called as execute. Agar aapne Java padha hai acche se, Java, in that you learn about Java database connectivity, so ye look like same dikhega. Okay, aisa alag nahi hai. Yeah, I know that there is a difference between connection, established connection statement, prepared statement, execute methods, execute query, execute up like that, but make a note of that. Near about they are same. Okay, they are working on the same platform, execute method. Here we need to pass the as a string, we need to pass the query. Okay, so for example, what query we need to execute? Just I want to retrieve the data from the database, and I have a table. The name of table is a select. So just I want to retrieve this data on my console. Yeah, mujhe retrieve karna hai. So what should I do here? I will use select all from. Just I want to write a query. Make a note of that. And database mein agar JDBC ke saath mein connectivity karna hai, more time. But we think hame Python ke saath karna hai ki we need to just write 4 to 5 lines. That's it. Well, while doing the program, we're using a Java as a JDBC Java database connectivity. We need to write at least 20 to 25 lines. At least 20 to 25 lines to retrieve the data. Okay, so in that we need to use loop. And so many things, like first we need to load the driver, establish the connection, use the statement, execute the query. After that, the result will be stored in a result set. After that, we need to print that. So at least 15-20 lines are there. So in that section only we return a 5 statements. You can say that we return as 5 lines. So just I will write 2 more lines and we get our data. Okay. So result.execute, make a note of that. Here we need to pass query. Pass. So we executed that. Now this statement will be executed. Now once we executed that data, now we need to freeze that data. Okay, so by using this command, the query will be executed. Now we need to retrieve that data. So what should I do? I will use one command called as a cursor.fetch. Fetch one record only. How to use that? I will write print data retrieve. Okay, this is an additional statement. Okay, so it is not mandatory to write this connection established. It is or not mandatory, but just I wrote for what, whether the connection is established, whether the data is written or something called. Okay, so don't worry about it. Return. In that the data will be retrieved. So just I wrote a line. For my understanding only, make a note of that. This is not compulsory. Okay, so just cursor.fetch. So this function, this method, the fetch one is a method which is available in a cursor, execute is a method which is available in cursor. So this method retrieves only one report. That will be your first report. This method will be retrieve only one record. We'll do, suppose if you want to retrieve more records, what we need to use, but just concentrate what we need to do. Just we need to establish a connection and do first practice. So once we complete it, so this is the way by using that we can do the operations. Okay. Now open the terminal and just try to implement that operation. Connection establish and data retrieve. In the last option, data retrieve, that means in that section we don't have any query at the end. Okay, we write all the program clearly. Okay, but we did not get the data. What is the reason behind that? Because the data is retrieved, but we did not print on console. Okay, so for that we have two options. Directly we can insert this inside print, or directly we can store that in one variable and after that we'll print it. Okay, I'll show you how we use print in round bracket. So just this method will be called inside the print method. That means the data will be printed on outside. Okay, just save it and try to execute it. See, we get the data. Connection established, data. So did we get the data which is entered in the first record? ID is there, name. In that section, we don't have an attribute. Make a note of that. Okay. If you want to create, then I have an option for that. So just I will write. So again, this is not mandatory, but this I am writing for only just for the clarity. Here I will use name. Okay, save it and just execute that program. Yes. That program. Okay, first name. This we need to arrange now. Now this thing will we need to arrange. is taking. ID is there, first name, थोड़ा सा पीछे, last name. It is not mandatory. Again, I can say that, but just for clarity purpose, just I wrote these lines. Okay, it's attachment. Now, okay, ID is there, first name is there, last name is there, and address is there. Okay, so this type of stuff you can do, but just this is a very basic program. Okay, while performing other operation, like in future, if you're doing the operation with Django and like that stuff, you have lots of options are available. Okay. So just I retrieve the data and just I will show you. I have the first record as Arvind Jadhav being displayed. Now I want to record two or more records. Just before that, I want to show one more thing. I don't want to use this inside the print. D is equals to. So D is what variable, and after that I will print that D. I assume that you have a basic knowledge of Python. I'm executing this. Just whatever result will be available, that will be stored in a D, and after that print the D, we get the same result. See, we did not get any other option, we get the same result. So we have two options to execute that. Now my query is, I want to fetch more records, what should I do? So here just we need to write, so that just I will use hash over here. Inside print, I will write that print round bracket cur cursor fetch etch fetch many. This is a function by using that we can retrieve the records. Fetch many in round bracket, we can click on the two. Fetch many, that means I want to retrieve two records, I want to record three records, I want to retrieve 10 records. So like that. So because I don't have a record, so I will fetch my only two records. Save it. Let's clear the screen and try to execute. We get the two records. Now in that section, there is no use of this line. Okay. No use of this line. Just I will remove it. But just make a note of that. Thus we retrieve the data. As we retrieve the data, and also I don't want to use a connection also. This is created for myself. Now check out the first record, and it will be treated as a list. See, square bracket open and square bracket. So this one is your first object. This one is your second object. Trying to retrieve. So what happened if you're trying to use three records, does we can retrieve that record? The answer is yes. Okay, ye maine existing database pe kyun nahi kiya, because we have a bunch amount of data and we're trying to retrieve that data. So aap confused ho jate, isliye maine khud se create karke bataya aapko tables. See, we have three records. 1, 2, 3. Last function is there, and just I will show you that function. Fetch all. In that section, all data will be displayed. CUR dot fetch option. Save it. So I'm trying to execute that. We get all. This is overall about what? This is the overall about, we can say that Python with establishing a connection with Python and PostgreSQL. We retrieved all the data. So we did the operation of, we say, retrieve operation. Like that, you can perform, you can fire a query to update the record, you can fire a query to insert the record, you can fire a query to delete the record. So you can do yourself. I will not provide. Okay. So see, everything, if I provide everything, then you cannot able to do the operation. You need to apply your own business logic to do the operation, to perform the task. Okay. Just I will show you the way. Okay. कहाँ जाना है, कहाँ पे करना है, क्या करना है, लाइक दैट आई विल शो यू द वे, जस्ट यू नीड टू डू द प्रैक्टिस. सो दिस इज अबाउट व्हाट सेलेक्ट ऑपरेशन. नाउ वी नीड टू क्रिएट अ टेबल इनसाइड योर डेटाबेस. Should I do? I will make a copy of that and I will create a new that program. CRE and just I will remove everything from this because right now I don't want to retrieve the data. So for that we didn't require the fetch one, fetch many like that stuff, and I don't want to pass the what we say, I don't want to pass the query also because I don't want to retrieve the data. I want to create a table, right? So we have to be table create. So what are the things we in that section? If you want to create the table, then we require to use attribute like again. So we require a query. Okay, so first of all, I will create one variable. And I will store a query inside that variable, and after that I will execute. So for that demo, so here I will use inside that I will use inside that I will use a string. It will be treated as, and we all know that this will be treated as string also, सिंगल कोट, डबल कोट एंड ट्रिपल कोट. ओके, ट्रिपल कोट क्यों यूज करना है? अगर मुझे डबल कोट के अंदर अंदर क्यूरी के अंदर अगर डबल कोट यूज करना पड़े तो, सो दैट्स व्हाई. सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. सो यूज ट्रिपल कोट इनसाइड दैट, यू कैन राइट विल बी बेनिफिटेड फॉर अस. सो हियर आई विल यूज क्रिएट. दे ऑल नो दैट आई विल क्रिएट द टेबल. टेबल नेम इज कॉल्ड एज अ टैंक. I want to create a demo table. So here I will specify the attribute user. If you want to set a primary key, then you can set right now. And user ID in here, I will choose the type as just basic information. Check karte whether we are working as a write or something. There will be a problem. Do not try to execute this program. What is the reason behind that? It will be created duplicate values, duplicate tables. Okay. So in that section, once we created, next time will be we get the different kinds of error. The table already exists. So just we'll write a full code and afterwards we'll execute. Okay. So we did that operation and we successfully created the query. Now what should we do? We need to execute that query. Okay. So cursor dot execute. We already learn about that. And in that we'll pass our attributes. Once we executed, we need to commit the operation. Commit means what? So agar nahi commit karte ho, it will be executed, but it will not create the table. Okay, it will be created and it will be rollback. Rollback means wapas waise aana. So that means we need to commit the section. So for that connection dot we need to call the commit method. Commit means we are storing permanent. We are doing a permanent changes. That's why. And afterwards. Close the connection. We didn't want to open the connection. So just kernel or intimate kernel. So that's why we need to use the simple connection dot. We use close. And just after that, I will write one simple statement which will specify one message. Everything is okay. That means we did successfully operation. So okay, I want to write table is created. Okay, so just space. the way by using that we can create the table. Once we save, so just we need to execute that. CRE, so just I will use py CRE. Execute. We get the message, table is created. Now we need to check whether the table is created. So inside that, I'm not able to view the table. Just right click it on and just refresh it. Check out whether the table is created. That demo is created. Now see, demo is there. What about columns? Click on that user ID and type. So just select every from execute. Integer and character. We get the output.
But here
we don't have any data. Means again we need to insert the operation, update, delete, like that stuff. Okay. So this is the overall about the Python, and the last lecture will be there is a completion of internship also there, so I will provide the certificate within the 2 days. Okay, so I will share the certificate on group, so you can check that. But I want to conduct one extra lecture. Okay. So that lecture, if you are interested, let me know about that. I want to conduct the extra lecture on timestamp. Okay, that was very useful to do the what, which type of data we can say that. Live data. If you want to deal with live data, then we require that information. Okay. Most of companies are working on the live data. So if you are interested, let me know about that. We'll do. I will arrange the session of 2 hours or 1.5 hour. Only one lecture. So in that section we'll cover all the concept related types, and for the final year student it's mandatory if you want to attend the interview right now. Okay, so just within 2 days your DB is completed. Now you need to create your own notes, you need to create a resume also, and after that we'll upload it on nookly.com. and again make a note of that, within a 7 days your call will be started as a fresh trainee DBA, or we can say that database management. Okay, so just we need to grab the opportunity. After the completion of degree, we'll decide which area we need to work. Okay, whether it is a development, whether it's a backend, whether it's a middleware, so you can decide also. But just we need to grab the opportunities. So for that, just be ready for within a 2 to 3 days. So we will start the interview related questions for the final year and for the final year student. So after that, I will share this interview question with 30 students. Don't worry about that. And if you want to clarify that answer, then I will clarify also. So just make a note of that. Part 1 and Part 2 are the compulsory. So just do the practice.